Hello, what is up, guys? Alexandros here. We are back with some fresh heat today, guys. And this one is kind of interesting. It's in the theme of superheroes, of Avengers. So if you are watching Marvel movies, then this one could be for you, okay? This one could be for you. It's called Avenger Coin. Ready to join the realm of heroes. Basically, it's a BSC coin, pretty new one as well, so there is a lot of development still to be made. They just recently got a price spot on their Telegram, and they recently locked liquidity as well to make it safe, you know. Still, we are waiting for some audits here, because another important part of all of these cryptos is being audited. This one has it, this one will have it as soon as possible. So yeah, I'm making this exception and I'm putting in a project without the audit, but that's because I have the liquidity lock link, okay? So I know that the liquidity has been locked, in fact, so that makes it safe. But obviously, I'm not a financial advisor. You should always do your own research, okay? Do your own due diligence before investing into anything that you see on the internet. I'm just a normal dude sharing you my opinions on certain projects, okay? So let's go through the website. The villains are taking over the coin universe by selling and dropping the price, but the heroes hold. To the Earth Tower heroes, 2% of the supply sold by villains will be distributed among you. Do you want to join our heroes? Join us by clicking the pancake swap link below and buying our coins so we can go to the moon. Alright. We have some tokenomics. It's basically a SafeMoon fork, so that also kind of makes it safe, alright? If it's a one-to-one fork, there is no backdoors in the code, you know. 1 quadrillion initial supply, half burnt at the start, 10% tax to penalize sellers, 8% is sent to the liquidity, so they are aggressively trying to have as much liquidity as possible, okay? And that's a good part, because liquidity is very important to make the price floor bigger and to make the project more sustainable, okay? Important stuff here. 2% is redistributed to the holders, so you are getting passive income by holding the token, okay? Whenever someone sells, whenever someone buys, whenever someone does something, you are basically receiving this passive income, okay? So yeah, we have the supply, 1 quadrillion, launch day 50% was sent to the dead address, so it was burnt basically, remaining 50% was added to the liquidity and burnt. So as you can see, 10% is charged on every transaction to generate automated liquidity. And then this is the 8% that is sent to the liquidity to create self-generated liquidity, and 2% is given to all the holders in proportion. Okay, cool stuff. They will also be launching NFTs, and that's pretty interesting because as you can see, they have some limited edition here. NFTs are very important nowadays because they are growing rapidly as well. So it opens a lot of new opportunities for this project, right? More potential investors to join in because of the NFTs. So that's kind of making them also stand out, right? And when it comes to those, you know, character coins, since it's on blockchain, copyright works kind of different here, okay? And as long as they make those custom, like, you know, superheroes NFTs, they can sell them, they can profit of them, they can, for example, invest that into the development, they can open a marketplace. As you can see here, they have the roadmap, and going through the roadmap, they will be listing on CoinGecko. They applied for it, they will be launching marketing campaign, then they will be aiming for a coin market cap listing. Obviously, there has to be some improvements made before that listing, so they have some time to do it. Whitebit fundraiser, so they will be trying on to get onto Whitebit as well, another important part when it comes to all those coins. And then we have the NFT marketplace that I was talking about and some exchange listings, so sounds good to me. Mobile superhero game, another cool stuff to say the least, okay? So they are on Twitter, guys, you can follow them, they have 50 followers, they are posting some information, as you can see, about the project. So if you are interested in getting on board, if you are interested in getting involved here, you can follow them on Twitter, okay? They also have this Telegram chat, as you can see, almost 1000 members, so they have established a really cool community here. It will be growing over time as well, so I'm looking pretty forward to that. And now the most important part, in my opinion, how to buy the token, okay? So there is 10% tax, which means that you will need some slippage, okay? So if you go to the pancake swap, if you want to get in with 1 BNB, you would get this much Avenger coin, okay? And now, if you want to purchase it, you might get an error, okay? If you click on swap, you might get an error that will be saying that there is some problem with your swap, etc, etc. All you need to do is just go here, click 11% of slippage, you should be good to go, okay? You can always test the lower amounts, because the more slippage you have, the more money it eats from you, okay? So just try to test out the proper one, if you ask people on Telegram, they will help you as well. So as you can see, it shows you that for one BNB you would get 691 something Avenger coin. And the fact is that you always have to look out at the minimum received, okay? Because the minimum received is in fact the amount that you will be getting for selling or for buying your tokens, alright? So just always be sure that you look at minimum received, and I like to say that to avoid the confusion when someone buys the token and they get less of it than it was shown on the PancakeSwap. And this applies to Uniswap as well, so just a little fun fact here as well. If you are interested in Avenger Coin, you can check them out. The link will be down below in the description. And that's it from me today. Thank you so much for watching this video, and see you in the next ones coming out.